I'm Sam Sheridan from Sheridan Computers. In this video, I'm going to show you how to set up wireless uplinks with UniFi equipment. Generally, I wouldn't recommend that you do this because setting up wireless uplinks will seriously hinder the link speed. But sometimes you don't have a choice, which is the reason that we're doing it. My client is in a listed building and they won't let us blow holes in any walls, as much as I do like doing that. So we have no choice other than to do a wireless uplink to do this. So I'm going to do this. I have engineers on site that are able to plug the access points in for me while we set them up. We'll configure the uplinks. And then we should be good and all running at the end of it. If you'd like to hire us for any Wi-Fi projects or any other IT related projects, please head over to our website at sheridan.co.uk and click on the hire us button. If you fill out the form, leave some details on what you're looking for and we'll get back to you. If you find this video useful, please hit the like button and consider subscribing to the channel in order to get updates of future videos. I'll leave some links in the description below to where you can get these access points. So let's go ahead and set up the wireless uplinks. So if we go into devices and select our access point, go to config. Under radios, the settings usually here. So in order to do this, we need to edit the site config. And enable connectivity monitor and wireless uplink. And if we do that, we now get the option to allow meshing from other access points. So that's cool, we've got that option. So this one I'm going to configure because I want it to actually mesh to another access point, and that's disabled by default. So in order to enable that, you need to go down to wireless uplinks and select allow meshing to another access point. Let's apply that. And it's provisioning. So once that's finished provisioning, then we can configure the master one. There's nothing that we really need to change on that. Once we've enabled the wireless uplink, we can go in and under radios, this is enabled by default, so it'll connect straight away. I just wanted to do a quick video on how to do this because the option wasn't there when I was looking for it. Obviously you need to enable it and I had it disabled. Okay, so I've switched the access points over, I've plugged the main one back in. So let's go and check this one. And you can see, as this one's set, it's allowing meshing from other access points. And then wireless uplinks, we have allow meshing to other access points disabled because we don't want it to mesh to other access points because this one's on a cable. The other one's located where we can't get a cable to it, which is the reason for doing this. Now when we plugged it in and we didn't enable allow meshing to another access point, it did come up with it flashed blue for about 5 seconds and then go off. I've seen a few people ask what that is. It's usually a network issue. So let's go in there. Plug the other one in and see if we get an uplink. Yes, I've had an engineer go upstairs with the access point that we've just configured to mesh. They've plugged a PoE injector into it. It's got no Ethernet cable in it and it's connected. We can see it. And if we, as you can see, the main one that we have in the office is an APAC Pro. And the one that we're meshing from is an APACLR. And you can see it says connected wireless. So that's it. If you've had any issues doing this, or you weren't sure how to do meshing between these access points, they do support it. We'll see how stable it is, but I just figured I'd record the video while we was doing it. If you'd like to hire us, head over to our website at sheridan.co.uk and click on the Hire Us button. Fill out the contact form, leave some details on what you're looking for, and we'll get back to you.